everyone. In this video, we will cover the current affairs. I am Nuzhat Sana. For mobile optimized ebooks, please install GK Today Academy app. You can attend the quizzes on this app for better practice. And after that, you can also read the detailed explanation of the questions you have missed. For regular updates, please check our Telegram channel. The link is given in the description box. You can subscribe to it if you find it relevant. For hard copy books, you can visit our website gktbooks.com. Okay. Also, our latest initiative is UPSC Prelims Test Series for 2021 and 2022 in GK Today Academy app. So if you are appearing in UPSC prelims, you may consider joining this. So now without wasting any further time, let's get started. So today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 10th and 11th of August 2021. Starting with very first question, according to the Central Universities Amendment Bill 2021, Sindhu Central University is to be established in which state or union territory? So recently on 6th of August, a bill seeking to establish a central university in the Union Territory of Ladakh was passed in the Lok Sabha. And regarding this bill, Education Minister Dharmendra Pradhan has said that every year around 7,000 students go out of Ladakh for education, and with the establishment of this central university, around 2500 students will get the opportunity to study here. And this central university will be established at a cost of 760 crore rupees. Now apart from it, Ladakh was also in news because recently BRO, that is Border Road Organization, has constructed the highest motorable road in the world at the height of 19,300 feet. At Lingla Pass in the eastern Ladakh region. And now this newly constructed road will connect the important towns in Chumar sector of eastern Ladakh. Now apart from it, few days back, Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade has notified about a new central sector scheme for industrial development of Jammu Kashmir with an amount of 28,400 crore rupees. And this scheme is applicable for any eligible industrial entity other than those which are run departmentally by the government. Also do remember that Ladakh is the first union territory to achieve 100% coverage of first dose COVID-19 vaccination. And in terms of city, the first city to achieve 100% COVID-19 vaccination is your Bhubaneswar. Question number 2. National Handloom Day is observed on which date? So recently on 7th of August, the Textile Ministry has celebrated the 7th National Handloom Day. So actually this day is celebrated to honor all the handloom weaving community and the people who are associated with it for their contribution in the socio-economic development of India. Now, 3 handloom craft villages are being set up by the ministry in collaboration with the respective state governments. And these villages are, first is Mohopara village, which lies in district Golaghat in the state of Assam. Second is Kovalam in Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala. And the third village is Kanihama in Srinagar. Okay. Now apart from it, recently on 8th of August, 79th anniversary of Quit India movement was observed. Because on this day in 1942, father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, gave the call of do or die, means karo ya maro, to all the Indians to drive Britishers away from the country. Then apart from it, International Day of Indigenous People is celebrated on 9th of August. And the theme for this year was Leaving No One Behind, Indigenous Peoples and Call for a New Social Contract. Also, 6th of August marks the 76th anniversary of world's first atomic bombing. Why? Because on this day, the United States had dropped the world's first atomic bomb on the city of Hiroshima in the year 1945, which destroys the city completely and kills 140,000 people. And further 3 days later, USA dropped a second bomb on Nagasaki, killing another 70,000 people. So finally, Japan surrendered on 15th of August which ends the World War II and its nearly half century of aggression in Asia. Now, can you tell me, when do we celebrate Vijay Diwas to mark India's victory against Pakistan in the Kargil War, and which is also known as Operation Vijay? Please write in the comment section if you know. Question number 3. Which ministry is implementing the PM Daksh Yojana? So, on 7th of August 2021, Dr. Virendra Kumar, who is our Union Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment, has launched this PM Daksh portal along with PM Daksh mobile application. So, this portal and app has been developed by Ministry of Social Justice in collaboration with NEGD to make skill development schemes accessible to the target groups of scheduled caste, then backward classes and safai karmacharis. Okay, so here correct answer is option number C. Do remember that from the year 2020 to 21, this yojana is being implemented by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Can you tell me what does Daksh stands for? It is Pradhan Mantri Dakshta Aur Kushalta Sampan Hitgrahi. Now, apart from it, under the Ministry of Defence, the Government of India has approved the establishment of Defence Cyber Agency. Why? To mitigate various type of cyber threats, all the three armed forces service have established their respective CERT, that is Cyber Emergency Response Team. Also, the Union Government is implementing Bharatiya Prakritik Krishi Paddhati Yojana, which is a sub-scheme of Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana since 2020 to 21, and it aims to promote traditional indigenous practices as it focuses on exclusion of all synthetic chemical inputs and promotes on-farm biomass recycling. Question number 4. In August 2021, which country became the latest entrant to the CDRI, that is Coalition for Disaster Resilient Infrastructure? So this CDRI was launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in the year 2019, and it has 25 countries along with 7 international organizations, and the latest entrant is Bangladesh. Why CDRI has been established? So, the basic aim of CDRI is to promote the resilience of existing and new infrastructure system to climate and disaster risk in support of sustainable development. Now, apart from it, Bangladesh was also in news because of its Haribanga mangoes, because recently Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has sent a consignment of this particular variety of mangoes to our Prime Minister Narendra Modi and West Bengal's Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee. And this event is also called as Mango Diplomacy. Apart from it, talking about some important products from India, recently Mishri variety of cherries have been exported to Dubai from Srinagar. Apart from it, first consignment of GI certified Shahi Lichi has been recently exported from Bihar to United Kingdoms. And India has also exported Jardalu mangoes, which are again from Bihar, to the United Kingdoms. Then apart from it, three products from Assam have been recently exported, and which are they? The first is Burmese grapes, which is also called as Letuku in Assamese language. These grapes have been exported to Dubai. Then the second product is Bao Dhan, or you can say it as red rice, and this has been exported to USA. The third one is a variety of lemon named as Kaji Nemu, and it has been sent to London. Now, can you tell me, the Gakki mushrooms, which has recently got the GI tag, belongs to which state or union territory of India? Please write in the comment section if you know. Question number 5. Recently, the Taxation Laws Amendment Bill 2021 was passed in Lok Sabha to remove the contentious retrospective tax provision in Income Tax Act. Who was the finance minister when retrospective tax provision was included in the year 2012? So
So recently, as we know that this taxation laws amendment bill was passed in the Lok Sabha on 6th of August. And the bill seeks to do away with the contentious retrospective tax provision. Actually, it proposes to amend the Income Tax Act 1961 to provide that no tax demand shall be raised in the future on the basis of the retrospective amendment for any indirect transfer of Indian assets. Till what time? If the transaction was undertaken before May 28, 2012. So at that time, Mr. Pranab Mukherjee was the finance minister when this retrospective tax provision was included in the year 2012. Now apart from it, recently, Factoring Regulation Amendment Bill 2021 has been passed by the parliament, and this bill has been passed to bring changes in the legislation for helping our MSMEs so as to improve the availability of working capital for MSME. Also recently, Lok Sabha has passed National Institute of Food Technology, Entrepreneurship and Management Bill. And it has awarded the status of Institution of National Importance to NIFTEM, that is National Institute of Food Technology, Entrepreneurship and Management, which lies at Kundli in Haryana. And IIFPT, that is Indian Institute of Food Processing Technology, which lies at Thanjavur, Tamil Nadu. Now, can you tell me which state government has recently passed a resolution in state assembly for creation of a legislative council in state under Article 169 of the Indian Constitution? Please write in the comment section if you know. Question number 6. Who is the highest wicket taker in the international test cricket? So this is the Sri Lankan spin, Mr. Muralidharan. And why it is in news? Because recently veteran England pacer James Anderson has surpassed Indian spin legend Anil Kumble, which had a tally of 619 test wickets. And this was done during the third day of the first test against India at Nottingham. So do remember that now only Mr. Muralidharan and Australian wizard Shane Warne are now ahead of James Anderson, okay? Now apart from it, can you tell me what is the title of autobiography of Major Dhyanchand? So the name is Goal. What happened is the Khel Ratna Award, which is India's highest sporting honor and named after former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi, is now rechristened in the honor of hockey legend Dhyanchand. So now this award will be called as Major Dhyanchand Khel Ratna Award. Now recently one more book was in news named as Nehru, Tibet and China. And this has been authored by Avtar Singh Bhaseen. Apart from it, Indian cricketer Suresh Raina has recently released his autobiography named as Believe, What Life and Cricket Taught Me. So this is the autobiography of Mr. Suresh Raina. Question number 7. Who is the current chairperson of National Commission for Women who recently got 3-year extension? So on 7th of August, Rekha Sharma was reappointed as the chairperson of National Commission for Women for another 3-year term, or till the age of 65 years or until further orders, whichever is the earliest. Now apart from it, Peru has its new president. It's Pedro Castillo. Then Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi has been appointed as Deputy Leader of House in Rajya Sabha. Then our new Chief Minister of Uttarakhand is Mr. Pushkar Singh Dhami. Apart from it, Twitter has appointed Mr. Vinay Prakash as Resident Grievance Officer to comply with the new IT rules of India. Then there is Rasbi Ranjan Das. He has been appointed as the member of UN Tax Committee for the period of 2021 to 2025. And the first MD of National Asset Reconstruction Limited is Padmakumar Nair. Now you have to tell me who is our current Minister of Civil Aviation. Please write in the comments. Question number 8. How many Indian players have won individual gold medal in Olympics so far? So as we know that on 7th of August, Neeraj Chopra won the gold medal in men's javelin throw at the Tokyo Olympics with a throw of 87.58 meters, which was just a monster throw. And with this, Neeraj Chopra becomes the first Indian to win a medal in athletics at the Olympic Games. And he is only the second Indian to win an individual gold medal after shooter Abhinav Bindra at Beijing in the year 2008. So here correct answer is option number 2. Also do remember that at the Tokyo Olympics, Netherlands won the women's hockey gold medal by beating Argentina. And in this, Great Britain defeated India with a score of 4-3 in the match between losing semi-finalist to win the bronze medal. Apart from it, wrestler Bajrang Punia won a bronze medal in the men's freestyle 65 kg category at the Tokyo Olympics after defeating Daulat Niyazbekov, who is from Kazakhstan. Also do remember that Mirabai Chanu and Ravi Kumar Dahiya are the two silver medal winners from India in the Tokyo Olympics. Now can you tell me which country won gold medal in men's football in the Tokyo Olympics? So it was Brazil. And Brazil defeated which country? Spain. Now you have to tell me who were the flag bearers for the opening ceremony of Tokyo Olympics. Please write in the comments. Question number 9. Ganga Pathway, which is said to be a version of Mumbai's famous Marine Drive, is being opened in which Indian city? So Patna is all set to get its own version of Mumbai's famous Marine Drive and it will be opened by next year. Actually, the Ganga Pathway project is a part of 3390 crore rupees project, which is coming on the southern bank of River Ganga to minimize traffic on the congested Ashok Rajpath. And the total length of project is 20.50 kilometers. Apart from it, do remember that Indian Institute of Heritage is to be set up in Noida. Also, Patna was in news because here National Dolphin Research Center is proposed to be constructed to conserve the endangered gangetic dolphin species in India. And also, Union Government has proposed to set up NRF, that is National Research Fund, to strengthen the research ecosystem in the country, and the proposed outlay of NRF is 50,000 crore rupees for over a period of 5 years. Coming to last question, recently which bank has been empaneled by RBI to act as an agency bank? So this is Karnataka Bank. So now Karnataka Bank will act as an agency bank to RBI to facilitate transactions related to government business. And now it will also be authorized to undertake government business such as revenue receipts and payments on behalf of the center and the states, then in terms of pension payments and collection of stamp duty charges. So these work along with any other item specifically advised by the RBI would be taken forward by the Karnataka Bank. Apart from it, do remember that Indian Bank and IIT Bombay has recently tied up for extending the credit facilities to startups and MSMEs. Also do remember that PhonePe has become the first digital investment platform to launch UPI-based auto-pay functionality for its mutual fund SIP, that is Systematic Investment Plans and Offerings in India. So now this UPI auto-pay function will be available for existing as well as the new investors on PhonePe app. Okay. Now can you tell me, RBI has recently cancelled the license of which bank due to its financial condition? Please write in the comments. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide, you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions. And at the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores in the comment section. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today. And we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Zatsana signing off.